Okay, so good morning, my dear GSTS student. Welcome again to another session, to our learning lesson for this morning. So we will tackle the historical antecedents in the course of science and technology, specifically the following: the Babylonian, Egyptian, and the Greek civilization. So at the end of the discussion, you should have first discussed the interactions between science and technology and society throughout history. Discuss how scientific and technological developments affect society and the environment. Identify the paradigm shifts in history. So last time, we talked about the Sumerian civilization, and there are some notable discoveries, inventions that we learned from that civilization. And now we will proceed with three other ancient civilizations that made an impact to science and technology course throughout history. So first, we have the Babylonian. So the Babylonian is very similar to the Sumerian civilization because it is located in Mesopotamian area near the Tigris and Euphrates rivers. The Babylonians were great builders, engineers, and architects as seen in their infrastructures and based from archaeological excavations that are still evident in some parts of Iraq and on that area of the Arabian Peninsula. Okay, they are known for the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, in which the construction of the Hanging Gardens, a wonder of the ancient world which some believe, was built by the biblical king Nebuchadnezzar II for his wife Queen Amethyst. No proof of existence for this structure, such as lack of documentation and archaeological evidence. One of the greatest engineering and architectural achievements of the world that is impossible to replicate. But inspirations from modern architects are linked to the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, in which they are using a green architecture on their structures. They put plants, they put greeneries, okay, on their buildings. What else? The chariot. So originally, carts were used for the transportation of goods and for traveling. Soon, they were being pulled by domestic animals, and this newly developed cart was known as a chariot. So originally, it is used for farming. It is used for transportation of their goods. But later on, the framework of the oldest chariot consisted of wood with a rim, and two-wheeled chariots were used in a battle and to transport weapons and other war provisions. So meaning, the chariots have been linked also to military activities and services. Okay, what else? So the Egyptian civilization na, and it is located in North Africa. It is known for their engineering feats, such as the infrastructures established by the pharaohs and queens. Other than their engineering technology, the Egyptians contributed other practical things that are essential until now. So it is located in the northeastern part of Africa, the African continent. Okay, and it is also near the Nile River. So the paper of papyrus, perhaps, okay, this is to correct the idea. Originally, based from the history of paper, the origin is in Chinese civilization. It was a plant that grew abundantly along the Nile River. The Egyptians processed the plants in order to produce thin sheets on which they could write down things. It was a major accomplishment for record keeping and communications during Egyptian civilization. But in the Eastern civilization, there are records in which na-consider yung Chinese origin of paper, first use of paper. But the Egyptian civilization has also their own way of producing paper using the plant papyrus. Okay, next, ink. In their writing, engraving ceased to be used in writing. As a result, the Egyptians invented ink. It is made from combining soot with different chemicals to produce inks of different colors. The ink must withstand the elements of nature and tamper-proof to avoid tinkering. And the record shows that really, they used ink in their paper-made papyrus for record keeping and for for art, okay, for telling stories and other literature. Okay, next. Hieroglyphics, like the Sumerians, Egyptians also developed a system of writing using symbols known as the hieroglyphics. They believed that this was provided by them to them by their gods. So they believed on many gods. It can still be seen in their famous pyramids carved at the walls. It tells about the culture and history of the Egyptians. And until now, it's very evident. Okay, this hieroglyphics is very evident on the walls of the pyramids. Cosmetics. It was invented by the Egyptians to improve and highlight the facial features of a person, and they believe that it protects them from evil. Its function is both for health and aesthetic reasons as a sign of holiness. Kohl was created by mixing malachite or soot with mineral galena. So in relation to our present times, cosmetics are also being used, especially for beautification, yan, for aesthetics nga. And comparing to the Egyptians, they believe that it protects them from evil spirits. Wig. It is worn for health and wellness rather than aesthetic purposes, unlike today. Why? Because they used to protect their shaved heads of the wealthy Egyptians, the pharaohs, the doctors, and professionals during that time, the skilled, from the harmful rays of the sun. So it's been a practice for them to shave their heads. And as a result, they need to protect it using wigs. Now, wigs are being used, okay, for aesthetics, and of course also for health din related to yon, for chemotherapy kapag nalalagas na yung buhok yon, para rin sa aesthetic pa rin yon. Okay, what else? Water clock or clepsydra. This device utilizes the gravity that affects the flow of water from one vessel to other. It is widely used for timekeeping devices during the ancient time. So they value much their time, so they need to devise something that can aid them to determine the time. So the use of water clock is very important. Sickle. So the sickle is a curved blade used for cutting and harvesting grains such as wheat and barley. So it's believed that it's a great tool for them because of food production. They need to produce more food, and the agricultural lands are being tilled, and the use of sickle, the wheel and plow during the Sumerian civilization also are evident and are very beneficial, helpful to their agricultural lifestyle. Mummification is also one of the things associated to Egyptian civilization. It is the lost art of embalming the dead. Mummification is the process of preserving the body after death by deliberately drying or embalming flesh. This typically involves removing moisture from a diseased body and using chemicals or natural preservatives such as resin to desiccate the flesh and organs. So until now, as you have heard, the golden parade of pharaohs and queens in Egypt, okay, they excavated several mummies of pharaohs, kings, and queens during their period, during these ancient times, and it is preserved. Okay, the bodies are preserved and well kept, and it is now situated to their new museum in Egypt, if you have heard that story or happening. Okay, so that's it. We move on now to the last civilization. We have the Greek civilization. Greece is an archipelago in the southern eastern part of Europe. Archipelago because it contains a lot of islands, just like the Philippines in our setting. We are an archipelago also. Known as the birthplace of Western philosophy, which includes in-depth works in philosophy and mathematics. They contributed much to the world, especially in the fields of science and technology. So before, there is no concrete study which is called science. So ang unang study pa lang noon ay philosophy, in which it is the birth of great thinkers, great influential thinkers such as Socrates, Plato, and we have also Aristotle. Yeah. mga naririnig nating mga famous names. Alarm clock. Okay, so just like the clepsydra in the Egyptian culture, Egyptian civilization, it's used as a large complicated mechanism to time the alarm, made use of water also, or sometimes small stones or sands, the drop into the drums which sounded the alarm. So every drop, okay, it counts for a certain time. And then the mechanism, so for example, there is a sound na masesensor using that stone or the water or yung sand. Plato was believed to have utilized alarm clock to signal the start of his lecture, who is founded the academy. And yun. So they value time well and they need a tool to help them determine what is the time already. Okay? Next, we have water mill. One of the most important contributions of the Greek civilization to the world. It is used for agricultural processes like milling of grains for food, processing, and mass production of rice, cereals, and flours. It is better than mills from farm because it requires less effort and time to operate, of course. So you just need the force of water to flow from the river in order to rotate that mill and for them to powderize or to grind or to mill the rice, corn, and cereal to become a flour that can be utilized in baking bread and other products, similar products. Okay, last, other inventions, cartography is the study of practice of making maps. It has played an important role in travel and navigation since ancient times. Even though the earliest known evidence of cartography points toward ancient Babylon, as early as the 9th century, the Greeks took what they had at their disposal and brought cartography into a new light. Anaximander was one of the first pioneer cartographers to create map of the world. In our time, we still use maps, very helpful in navigation and travel, but to the advent of satellites such as the global positioning system, GPS, we can still access maps through our mobile phones, through our smartphones, with just a connection to the internet. Okay, next. Discoveries in science are also associated or very important contributions of the Greek civilization, in which they made some outstanding discoveries in the fields of astronomy, biology, and physics that broke with contemporary stereotypes. Aristotle introduced the idea of the earth as a globe. He also classified animals and is often referred to as the father of zoology or the study of animals. Theophrastus was the first botanist that we know of in written history. The Pythagorean theorems, Pythagoreans not only made the earliest advances in philosophy and geometry, but they also proposed the heliocentric hypothesis of the earth revolving around the sun, which is also a proposal of Nicolaus Copernicus in the Renaissance time, okay, during the scientific revolution period. Okay, ponder on this question. You can comment below your answer to this. What do you think is the most important contribution of the Babylonian, Egyptian, and Greek civilization and why? Okay, so this will be your bonus point, okay, in your class standing. Okay, so I hope you learned a lot with these three equally important civilizations, the Babylonian, the Egyptian, and the Greek civilization. So next meeting, we will again learn another ancient civilization that made an impact on the course of science and technology through and our society. Okay, so that's all. Thank you for your active listening. God bless and stay safe.